Hello everyone, the topic for paper presentation is the efficiency of ultrasound in comparison with NCCT for urolithiasis detection in the urinary tract. The aim of this study was to determine the accuracy of ultrasound for detecting the urinary tract stone by using CT as the gold standard reference. The gold standard imaging modality to diagnose urinary tract stones in patients with acute flank pain is NCCT with a sensitivity of 95% to 98%. High ionizing dose, high rate of incidental findings, and high dose of NCCT are the limiting factors to its widespread use. On the other hand, ultrasound is widely used for detecting the renal stones. It is a safe, non-invasive, and cheap method, and in circumstances such as pregnancy and pediatric age, it is the modality of choice for calculi detection. However, many factors such as body weight, age, and stone size affect the diagnosis of uretric stone using the ultrasound. Renal stones can be radiopaque or radiolucent. 80% of all the renal stones are composed of calcium oxalate and phosphate, which are radiopaque. 15% are composed of struvite, 1% of cysteine, and 4% of uric acid or xanthine, or are matrix stones. Matrix stones and those composed of struvite, uric acid, or xanthine are radiolucent. Patients and methods. The inclusion criteria. In this study, we included patients of all age group, and this study was conducted on 229 patients who visited the emergency department and general OPD of our institute. Exclusion criteria. All patients with Stagon stone and urinary tract diversions, those who received NCCT in other hospitals, patients with a time interval of more than 1 month between ultrasound and NCCT, those with the probability of stone displacement, and pregnant women were excluded from this study. Abdominal ultrasound acquisition. Ultrasound was performed using grayscale ultrasound equipment using a 3 to 5 MHz curved transducer. Since a small stone may not cause an acoustic shadow, all echogenic foci seen in the renal pelvis, ureter, or calluses on ultrasound were diagnosed as urinary tract stones. The sensitivity and accuracy of ultrasound for detecting urinary tract stone were recorded. Furthermore, the stones were classified according to their size into four groups: 0 to 3.5, 3.6 to 5, 5.1 to 10, and more than 10 mm using NCCT as the gold standard. Abdominal CT acquisition. All upper abdominal area to the pelvis scan images were obtained with one CT system. The patients were scanned in supine position during breath holding. The main imaging parameters were tube voltage of 120, automated tube current modulation of 30 to 70, pitch of 0.9 to 1.2 mm, matrix of 512 into 512, slice thickness of 10 mm, field of view of 315 to 350 mm. All the images were then reconstructed at 1 or 2 mm interval. So in this study, 276 stones were detected by NCCT in 184 patients, while ultrasound could detect 213 stones. The mean sensitivity of the ultrasound was 72.6%. The mean age of the patients was 47.7 years. The mean left and the right side stone detection was 47% and 54% respectively. The mean weight of the patient was 69 kgs. The mean stone size in NCCT was 8.8 mm. To obtain the accuracy of the stone size measured by ultrasound, we compared the stone size of both NCCT and ultrasound. About 73% concordance was obtained for the stone size measured by ultrasound and NCCT. The gold standard modality used for detecting renal stones is NCCT, whereas ultrasound is used as the initial investigation due to easily available with non-use of radiation, cost-effective and repeatable. In the current study, in line with the literature reports, sonography was less sensitive than NCCT in initial detecting stones when located in the mid or distal part of the ureter, and this may be due to the obscurity by the bowel gas. Despite all these differences, in a study, the sensitivity of ultrasound for the detection of stones was similar to that previously reported, that is about 72.6%. In a study, about 73% concordance was obtained for the stone size, confirming the reliability of the stone size measured by ultrasound and suggests that ultrasound might be adequate and worth performing. The detection rate of specific stone by ultrasound was examined for different locations. It was found that the detection sensitivity rate was low in the mid and distal part of the left and the right ureter of 42.8% and 53.5% and 50% and 60% respectively, and maximum sensitivity of ultrasound for stone detection was at renal pelvis followed by lower pole of each kidney. So this is the data required for both the right and the left kidney, and the sensitivity was measured. So these are the images. Ultrasound KUB of a 65-year-old male showing an echogenic focus with posterior acoustic shadowing seen at the right mediurator, and the CT coronal image showing hypertense calculus at the same location. However, ultrasound overestimates the size. Ultrasound size was 7.7 mm and CT was 7.1 mm. So this is KUB of a 34-year-old male showing an echogenic focus with posterior acoustic shadowing at left VUJ, and the CT axial of the same patient was showing an hypertense calculus at the same location. Ultrasound overestimating the size to be 8.1 mm and the size of the CT to be 7.6 mm. Ultrasound abdomen of 38-year-old and 24-year-old male showing an echogenic focus with posterior acoustic shadowing seen at the lower pole and calculi with prominent pelvic alveolar system in the right kidney respectively. CT images of 46 and 57-year-old female showing hypertense calculus at right PUJ causing mild hydronephrosis and hypertense calculus at left mediurator respectively. Coronal and sagittal CT images of 37 and 65-year-old female showing hypertense calculus at right lower calyx and hypertense calculus at left VUJ respectively. Coronal CT image of 55-year-old male and 44-year-old female showing small size right renal calculi and left renal calculus which were missed in ultrasound. So the conclusion is the stone size obtained by sonography was almost the same as that detected by NCCT in most of the cases. Ultrasound may slightly overestimate stone size in some cases. Also, it has limitation in detecting the urinary tract stone, especially in the case of smaller stone size, obese patient, and low grade of HTN. However, ultrasound still plays an important role in the primary diagnosis of patients with suspected urinary tract stone as well as during the follow-up. These are the references. Thank you.